Hello and welcome back to episode 2 of Death Stranding Blind Playthrough. Last episode we started this series, which is pretty intense. A few things that we learned is the main character, his name is Sam Porter Bridges. He actually represents a character from The Walking Dead, his name is Daryl, but I don't think there's any correlation between The Walking Dead and this game. It's just interesting that he used that as a character, and I've yet to search that and see what that means. We know that Sam Porter Bridges has dooms. Somehow it makes him some sort of immune to what's going on in this place. There's a bunch of creepy black or invisible monsters called BTs, which we haven't learned the name of those yet. But whenever a BT is present, Sam Porter Bridges tears up. There's another lady we met the very first episode named Fragile as well, and she's very similar to that. Also has dooms and tears up because of an allergy. The weird thing is apparently there are different stages or levels to this dooms. We started out not being able to see these creatures at all. Well, at the very end of the episode, which was about an hour in, we then saw these creepy character, like four people lined up in the distance. I'm not sure if they were dooms or that weird cloaked guy with the baby attached to him that floated down and told us something was coming. I also noticed, and I didn't notice this during the gameplay, and if you go back and check it out in case you didn't notice, the guy, the driver, who was driving us to this area where we were going to incinerate the body, seemed to grow older as he was lying there under the truck. Like, his hair is getting grayer, his face is getting more old features, it was getting more wrinkly. And I thought that was strange, and I wonder if they're going to mention that. Another very weird thing is the babies in these incubators. The only thing I can think of right now is that's how they reproduce. That's how they get babies, maybe with doom, so they're immune to this infection or whatever these BTs are. And then the last thing it showed was a scar on Sam's stomach. So I'm interested. These are like a bunch of kind of things that I noticed. I'm assuming we'll get the answers to these. Anyways, we followed a woman, I'm assuming who was our mother, singing a lullaby into the water. So here we are in the water, and I think that we are trying to get out. So I think we have to go towards that, but who's this? Hi. What the heck? What the heck? What?
BB? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Steady.
Well, that was strange. We have the incubator back. Oh, gosh. He's crying.
Once there was an explosion, a bang which gave rise to life as we know it. And then came the next explosion. An explosion that will be our last.
Huh. Assuming the explosion he's talking about is like the Big Bang? I'm not sure. And then the next explosion, we're not sure. Must be what this scenario is. Oh, this is so interesting. So that was weird. We were in the water. We went down his throat to find the baby, also in his stomach. And then there's a dude who said, Daddy's here, and this is called BB. So is that the baby, or was that supposed to represent Sam? I am so confused. This game is not giving me any answers. But I also decided that kind of any exploration I do, I might just cut out most of it. Most of this is really going to be for the story. Obviously, if anything fun or exciting is happening, I will include that in here. But just standard exploring, I'm going to kind of chop those pieces out when I'm just running around. He sure passes out a lot. Episode 1, Bridget. Huh.
Oh, you're awake. So, how does it feel to be back in the world of the living? Don't worry. I'm a doctor. Well, a coroner, originally. Call me Dead Man. I'm well acquainted with the dead. Not like you, of course.
Dead Man.
Contrary to the name, I've never actually died.
Do you see the scarring on his forehead?
I would advise against that. I'm no expert, but I can assure you it's for your own protection. See?
So I'm a prisoner.
These aren't handcuffs. They're cutting-edge devices that keep us all connected.
Us? Oh, us.
Yep. Bridges. Humanity's best hope for the future. Or avoiding extinction, if you prefer.
Right. Where am I? What time is it?
Watch me. Try pressing it against your skin. Like this. Relax. That just means your body's got a good connection to the cufflink. Look, look. The cuffs will watch over you 24 hours a day. That is to say, we will. We're here to help.
What the hell? 2 days?
During that time, we took the liberty of collecting fluid samples from you. You're a repatriate. That makes you very special.
What happened to the CD guys?
Central Knot was obliterated in the annihilation. Game over, man. Place is a crater.
Is that where we were just
the
at?
The only ones to get to continue were you. For obvious reasons, and your broken bridge, baby.
Is it all right?
It's been marked for disposal. Didn't work anymore. Why keep it? We lost everyone. Not just corpse disposal. My team, HQ, all of Redefort, every soul in Central Knot City. We're at our base, in Capital Knot City now. Or should I say, our new headquarters. Sudbury seemed the logical choice. But our implementation team has been decimated. And there's only so much they can do in 2 days. Things here are a mess. Fortunately, the director and his support team were out of town at the time, so the chain of command remains intact. I hate to do this so soon, but I have a job for you.
I just got out of bed, dude.
This stencil is from when you repatriated? What's the other mark from?
A clinging woman in a cave.
I see. Aphanphosmophobia. No wonder you were out there alone, where no one could touch you. I'll try to be more careful, Sam. So, the job is an urgent delivery. I need you to bring the president some morphine.
What president? America's gone. You talking about the mayor of Central Knot?
No. Not the mayor. America lives on, Sam. The president is in the final stages of cancer, in critical condition, but there's still time.
Why me?
Look, Sam. Do as I ask, and I promise it will all make sense.
Why don't you do it?
Because I'm not really here.
Plot twist.
Apologies. This is just a chirogram. And here, come the tears. Allergic reaction to the chiral transmission. I'm actually over in the isolation ward in the big triangle building. Here is the morphine. Bridges hereby enters into a contract with Sam Porter.
Come on, you got morphine there. What's this about? Tell me the truth.
The truth, Sam, is that America's last president wants to see you in person. Are you really about to say no?
Watch it be Trump. What are you going to say, Sam? Of course we're going to do it. We're not going to turn down that kind of adventure.
Very good. I'll see you in the isolation ward.
Another thing that I didn't exactly mention last episode was that the baby had left handprints on Sam, and those handprints didn't go away, similar to the other handprints kind of imprinted in his body.
Beginning scan.
So that's
scan
another thing I want to question too. But anyway, it looks like deliver morphine to Bridges isolation ward. Welcome. You don't have number of Sam's items required for the I have to get more items. Alright, I guess we're gonna do a little bit of exploring. Let's see. Oh, I should probably
delivery order for Sam Porter.
Carry. I should probably bring the morphine with me.
Isolation ward for immediate administration to the president.
Interesting. I have so many questions to this game. Like they leave you with so many unanswered questions. They still haven't mentioned the BTs. They act like it's totally normal, which I guess in their world it probably is.
Access to delivery terminal denied.
But I think that we have to go this way. Another thing, and maybe I missed it. I thought his full name was Sam Porter Bridges. But this is called Bridges. So is he related somehow to whoever owns this? Or are certain people given that last name?
Check the map on your cufflinks if you're lost, Sam. The isolation ward should be pretty obvious. If you're not sure how to get there, you can set markers and draw routes too.
Thanks, dude.
Try it out and you'll see what I mean.
I will do that because I have no clue what an isolation ward is supposed to look like. Is this what I'm looking for? Destination. Cool. Oh, wait a minute.
Hello?
I also don't get why I can square and then L to plan route. Oh, that's pretty neat. So I can hold this and then it will tell me where to go. Alright, so we've drawn our marker and it's going to tell us exactly where we need to go. That's pretty cool. That's helpful for noobs like me. So I guess we're going to go drop off this morphine. While I'm running around here, I want to know, guys, have you played this game? If you've tuned in today, or even on episode 1, have you played this game? I know some of my followers have not, and this isn't
Sam. Your friendly neighborhood dead man here. If you want to confirm you're headed the right way, check your compass. It'll never steer you wrong. Provided you have a destination, that is.
Where's my compass? L1. Awesome. Okay. So it's like a... Nice. I really like this interface. It looks really nifty. But yeah, let me know below. Have you played this game? Is this a new game for you and you're just wanting to watch it? As you know, this is a blind playthrough, so I've never played this game, heard of this game, know anything about this game. Why are you walking?
Central wasn't just home to Bridges HQ. It was also the seat of the Reconstructionist movement. If the president hadn't required special treatment, she would have never left. And if she hadn't, we wouldn't have either.
Okay, okay. Makes sense, I think. Still trying to wrap my head around all of this, but it looks like we've made it to the Isolation Center. It really seems like a cool story. I don't know about the gameplay yet. We haven't really got into much of it. But I know he keeps trying to walk and run and it's bothering me. We need a shower. Bridges. Yeah, there's gotta be some correlation between him and this Bridges company. He also said it was special with reapparitated, and I'm not sure what that word means. I'll have to look it up. But I guess we'll find out. I'm sure the game will answer our questions. Or at least my questions. Maybe everybody knows already and I'm just being a noob. But that's the point. But I'm curious. I'm curious to get out of dances.
Like I said,
more cutscenes.
Signs are all trending the same way.
No chance of a recovery then.
None that I can see. No.
Is she the president?
Sam. It's me, Dead Man.
You're hard to miss.
Sorry, my mistake.
You literally had me walk that across the...
I'm afraid the president's condition has deteriorated. Thank you. This will help to ease the pain. And allow her to speak with you in these final moments.
President is a girl.
The first and last female president of the United States. Surely you remember her. She raised you? You're not exactly dressed for a reunion. Take that off before you come inside.
Get naked. Let's do it. We like to live dangerously. Okay. So her must be the lady we saw at the lake, maybe? Oh, we got an S for walking across the parking lot. Sweet. We are pros. But when he says raise, I don't think biologically. I think it must mean inside of the that little... incubator womb thing.
That's the right-hand man, the director of Bridges.
Die Hard Man?
Oh, you were with Bridges One. So, I guess no introductions are necessary.
What's it been, Sam?
Die Hard Man.
10 years. Look at us. A bunch of deathless freaks meeting like this. Yeah, well, good to see you two. President's waiting. It's your mother, Bridget. She's a bit out of it, but I know she'll recognize you.
Madam President, we've brought Sam. We'll leave you two alone.
Sam. I knew you'd come back. Are you doing all right? Amelie. You remember Amelie went west. Took her 3 years to cross. She's trying to rebuild the country.
Still going on about that, huh?
You're the one I wanted to send, Sam. Time's running out. Help Amelie. She needs you. Together, you can help us reconnect. You can make America whole. Sam, if we don't all come together again, humanity will not survive.
We don't need a country. Not anymore.
We do. Alone, we have no future.
No, America's finished. Bridget, you're the president of jack shit.
Sam, listen to me.
What did you do, jerk?
I love you, Sam. I'll be waiting for you on the beach.
Madam President! Oh, no.
Nobody's gonna question why she's on the floor.
Doctor, we need your help. I love how she still has to die fancy. Oh. Be stranded with love.
Listen, no one can know that the president is dead. If word gets out, Bridges is finished. Now, what happened here does not leave this room. Do you understand?
Yes, Director. But there's still the matter of the body. Without corpse disposal.
We've got that covered.
You're gonna make Sam do it. No, that's evil.
Sam, Before she died, the president made a contract with you.
What are you talking about?
As a member of Bridges, you're gonna work with the rest of us to rebuild America.
You think you can recruit me? Like she tried to?
Well, she succeeded. Look at your wrist. If that's not symbolic, I don't know what is.
Director, the cancer spread throughout her entire body. Harvesting organs is out of the question, and there is no need for an autopsy. Her body needs to be cremated before she necrotizes.
And if we don't, this place will turn into another crater.
What do you want me to do?
We don't have any porters right now. And the CD team you went into the field with are dead. But the president's body has to be burned.
The road from Capital Knot City to the incinerator was compromised in the void out. Now the only way there is on foot, through the mountains. But the chiral density there is off the chart. It's gotta be BTs.
This job has requirements. Tombs. Repatriate.
So me? Why?
Sam, you're already on the clock.
Now get it done, Sam Porter Bridges.
Sam is his name. Porter is his job. And Bridges means he was part of this Bridges thing. That's what I'm thinking anyway, from what it sounds like. But I can't believe what just happened. So the president is dead. Who was his mother? Biological or not, I'm not sure. And now he has to be the one to walk on foot to this destination to burn her body, or another crater's gonna implode. Alright, I think I caught all that. This is one fancy funeral for a president. They also mentioned dooms and replicated.
President Strand believed in American Reconstructionism. She worked tirelessly to bring the nation together again. And without her, there would be no Bridges. She deserves a funeral with full honors. But we can't give her that. If she dies, America dies.
Without her, Bridges will cease to be.
Listen. Her cremation must be carried out with the utmost secrecy.
Even if we pull it off, what then? Who's gonna take her place? Face it. America's history.
Sam, America isn't dead yet.
He just said that it dies if Bridget dies.
She may be lost to us, but we still have an America worthy of the presidency.
Sorry, what?
Let's not get into it now. What matters is that we're going to finish your mother's work and rebuild America as she intended. That's the reason Bridges exists. So take the first step, Sam, and deliver the president's body to the incinerator.
If we don't all come together again, humanity will not survive. You're the one I wanted to send, Sam. Time's running out. I love you, Sam. I'll be waiting for you on the beach.
Oh gosh. Just gonna load her on my backpack? You know how incredibly heavy that would be?
Southwest. Remember that you'll be passing through BT territory.
We built the incinerator way up in the mountains, so that the chiral matter in the smoke wouldn't reach the city. It won't be easy, carrying a body up there.
Huh.
We'll be monitoring you around the clock. If anything comes up, we'll offer you support by the cufflinks.
Sure, thanks. So obviously we are immune to whatever this is. Obviously we are something absolutely special. They seem afraid to leave this area. But let's check our map real quick. South. We have to travel all the way over here. Are you serious? Place marker. So now I can do this business. Well, I obviously want to come this way. And then this way. Is this the river I can cross? I guess I'll have to come up here first and then cross at the weakest point. And then crawl through here, right? And then this looks like the entry point, so we'll just assume that's the case. Let's hope that's the way we have to go. I mean, it looks like the most logical route. I don't think I can go this way, because look, these mountains are too high. So I think that'll be the best way right now to go. But we'll find out when we get there, right? So let's deliver this president's body.
This is Die Hard. Dead men explain how to use the cuffs, right? Use them to check the location of the incinerator.
Open cufflinks to view map. Yeah, I already did that. It's ahead of you. Sorry.
Well, Sam, I don't think I need to.
I almost fell over.
Every minute counts when transporting corpses for disposal. 48 hours following cardiac arrest, they go necro and become a fresh BT to make our lives hell.
Really? Oh gosh, so I have to hold the L2 and the R2 button to stay balanced, which also means I can't run. So this is going to be a long journey, which I guess we should have expected that, right? Because we're carrying a body? Corpses are more liable to sway from side to side than regular cargo. If you begin to lose your balance, use L and R, try to steady yourself. Well, that's annoying. This is crazy. I can't wrap my head around it. So she'll turn BT though if we don't incinerate her body.
President Bridget Strand was the symbol of American Reconstructionism. Even with the country shattered and its people scattered to the four winds, she never stopped believing they could be reunited. People held on to their hope that America would rise again because they believed in her. Oh. We believe that this country can be rebuilt. America lives on. Together with Bridget's undying spirit.
I was ready to bounce off that wall. Man, so this is crazy. So we're going to be going through BT territory as well. Obviously we're immune. Because the big scary BT dude did not take us away when he took everything else away. We also learned that these things are bodies. So that's why when they're crawling around... Oh god, is that a BT? That's why when they're crawling around they look like handprints. Because they're people, right? What the heck was... Something was shaking the earth.
God damn it.
What? Yeah, I'm sure you're exhausted. Gosh, I can't even carry my 4-year-old through the store anymore. It's just like 30 pounds. Oh, some more beautiful music. So this isn't... You know, I was really expecting to come into this game as some sort of like shooting adventure type game. So far it has not proven to be like that. I don't have any weapons. All I have is that little machine that claps when those BTs are near. And we're just a simple delivery man. Obviously we're special, but we're still just a simple delivery man. So I think that's very interesting. I'm hoping this is the way we need to go. It wouldn't make any sense to cross through all the rivers when up here we can cross. I guess we'll find out. Alright, let's see if we can't cross. Oh crap. See if we can't cross this river real quick. Ah, there we go. Okay, perfect. We're gonna fall, we're gonna drop on mama. Okay, alright, we're good. I mean, there's nothing. Oh gosh, quit falling. I mean, there's nothing. I've kind of scanned around There's nothing to get, so our main objective is literally just to go up this mountain. We only have 48 hours, but I mean, that's 2 days, and I mean, not that we're halfway there, but we're getting there. But this is this. I don't even know. This is absolutely insane. Well, the music stops. Something's gonna happen. There's some sort of ladder down there. Bugs. Well, I refuse to eat those if I don't have to. Nasty things. I think it's interesting how they made it so you could make markers on the map, though. That's a really nice feature. Instead of having to pull the map up every, you know, 20, 30 steps to figure out which way you need to go next. So that's actually really nice. I've made some good distance. And hopefully I wrote the right path for where we need to go. Okay, press R1 to use the terrain scanner. The terrain scanner surveys the area, detecting, marking dangerous points. And it can increase the level of risk.
God damn.
Oh, look, the little black thing's coming off the body. She's starting to do whatever it is that happens. Okay. So let me pull the map up real quick to make sure. How do I zoom in? Oops. No? No? There we go. Pretty sure I'm going the right way. Can't go that way. Yeah, we're getting there. I'm gonna have to fall down though, or climb down. Seems like the best opening area. I literally have to hold down this R2 L2 thing though, because we lose balance so often. And then there's these little ladders up here. And there's a pulsing purple light. What's that? The electrical, maybe? Oh, they're literal ladders that I have to climb? No way. How am I gonna climb a ladder with this B-word on my back? It must be. They're there for a reason. I'm going the right way, boys. Thank goodness.
Just a bit further now.
You're right, Sam. Just a bit. It's like the game of chutes and ladders. Like?
This one's for you.
Like and be liked. I liked the ladder. That didn't make any sense. What does this even mean? Am I playing online without even knowing it? This is interesting. Let me like this one. Like.
Thanks for the help.
Okay. Well, whoever you are, I appreciate it. Now let me come across. Oh my gosh, I have to walk across it. Are you kidding me right now? You're asking me to fall. But okay, we made it up. Good job. Grab rope. Like. That is so weird. I can like these things. I can't like it again. Did an online player put this here? Sending multiple likes at once can be pressed repeatedly. And now I can climb up the rock. Alright. We made it up. That was pretty... No. That was pretty interesting. I don't know who Igor is, but I appreciate you, man. Hey, did I find it? There's no way I found it.
Anybody hear me?
What is this place? No, that's it. That's it, guys. Wow, we made it. Let's go.
So that's the place.
That's the place. Oh gosh, look. West of Capital Knot City. Incinerator. That's a pretty big piece of work there. Do you hear something? I swear I just heard a baby. And speaking of babies, that death dude, the professor, coroner, he threw away my baby. He's like, oh, that one's defective, and he just tossed it. That doesn't, like, that's so heartless. They must be used to it, though. I can't... You can save your current process. I haven't saved yet. Are you crazy? I could have lost all that. How do I do that? Oh, I haven't saved yet. On it. That's scary. Anyway. Here we are. Look at those things floating. Those BTs are... That large dude is close. Incinerator. Oh, that's nuts. Awesome. Guys, I have to end the episode here. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're enjoying this series. It is an intense game. Obviously, I'm asking a lot of questions, not directed towards you guys. Please don't put any spoilers, but it's just, this game really gets you thinking about everything that's going on. Don't forget to like the video if you've enjoyed, and subscribe if you want to keep up with the series, and I hope to see you guys around next time.